Number of sides equals 1/2 of 4 equals
1/2 of 4 equals. Now in this lesson we work with the surface area of cylinders. Now let's consider this cylinder here. The radius is R and the height H. We need to think of the surface area as being made up of the two lids and the curved surface. So let's write that down. We come up with the formula SA equals. Well, the two lids firstly, that's the top lid and that's the bottom lid if you like. Okay, both of them are circles. And the area of a circle is pi r squared. But since we have two of them, let's multiply by 2. So we have 2 pi r squared so far. Then we need to add the curved surface. So that's the surface around the tin, if you like. Okay, if you think of it a tin. So let's think of it as a tin with a label on it, and we're cutting the label off it. So we make a cut there and unwrap it. Right, now that length shown there is the height. So let's mark it in as h. What about this longer length? Well, let's go back to our original diagram there. If we considered it, it's a point, and if we went right around the tin, right, that is pi d, because that is the circumference, all right, the formula pi d. So the curved surface, it has area, length is pi d, the width is h, so the area pi dh. Okay, simply multiplying those two measures. Right, let's do some examples now. We need to find the surface area and we need to answer correct to one decimal place. There's our formula there. And rather than try to commit that to memory, it's better to consider how we actually arrived at that. Okay? So here we go, 2 pi r squared, where the radius is 3. So 2 times pi times 3 squared. Then we add pi dh, okay, d the diameter. So the diameter there is 6 centimeters, okay, double the 3. So the height is 8, so we're adding pi times the 6 times the 8. And when we calculate that, comes out to be 207.3 square centimeters. It's been rounded off to one decimal place. Excellent.